Today we're talking about Mike Pompeo, the new head of the State Department, after we decided that maybe having an ex-oil man dictating our foreign policy was a little too on the nose. Although they should be talking to a therapist, North Korea has instead decided to negotiate with Mike Pompeo. Unfortunately for coverage, these negotiations are no longer going on between the name-brand political leaders Trump and Kim, and have been passed to the Secretary of State Pompeo and North Korean Foreign Minister Ri Yong-ho. And because of that, the news is generally treating this like the part of the concert where the band says, "Alright everyone, we're gonna try some of our new songs." I'm gonna go to the bathroom, check the news, and let me know if anything crazy happens. Also, North Korean Foreign Minister? That's gotta be one heck of a job. How are foreign relations going, Minister Ri? Well, I just finished editing this video of a nuke hitting New York, so I think I'm gonna call it early today. As you can imagine, these negotiations are going about as well as me trying to negotiate with the call could not be completed at this time message. So why are we talking about this today? Well, a week ago this happened.
New this morning, we're talking about Secretary of State Mike Pompeo met North Korea's foreign minister at the ASEAN summit today.
Alright, we're shaking hands and talking. That's a start. Well, actually, that might be more of an end, because 2 days ago, the North Korean foreign ministry, having apparently beaten 2048 and solitaire and desperate to continue to look relevant, released a statement saying, "The issue in question is that, going against the intention of President Trump to advance the DPRK-US relations, some high-level officials within the US administration are making baseless allegations against us, and making desperate attempts at intensifying the international sanctions and pressure." So North Korea has shifted their strategy from aggressive to passive-aggressive. Instead of fire and fury, it's a post-it note your roommate leaves on your door saying, "Hey America, now I'm not gonna name names, but some of your high-ranking diplomats, well, they're making a mess in our common area. If you could just have them stop doing that, that would be great." More specifically,
on Thursday, it denounced US calls for international pressure over its nuclear weapons. The North also pointed out recent shows of good faith, stopping nuclear tests and returning the remains of American soldiers. But it said the US can't expect progress while aggressively pushing for sanctions at the same time.
Before we talk about the future of these negotiations, let's check out those concessions. So they did give us back the remains of 55 US soldiers that they killed, and that's good. Not dumb enough to make a joke about that one. More substantively though, what's going on with those nuclear tests? Did they stop them? Well, they didn't stop them, but they did destroy one of their nuclear test sites. Although, not by choice. Turns out there's no easier way to destroy a nuclear test site than to test one too many nukes in it, as North Korea recently found out when a recent study by a group of geologists discovered that the mountain used by North Korea for its nuclear bomb testing has collapsed as a result of the explosions. The specific testing site they're talking about in that video was a rocket testing site, though.
According to analysis of new satellite imagery, the North Koreans appear to be taking apart a missile engine test stand at a site where they had been sending rockets and satellites into space. It is an encouraging sign for the Trump administration.
Well, that footage, taken on July 23rd, is good news, and satellites have continued to observe it being taken down as of August 8th. Although critics are saying that North Korea has already created an ICBM capable of reaching the United States, so dismantling this test site is like acing the SAT and then announcing, "Well, I'm not taking that again." Still though, progress, because their missiles are about as likely to find their target location as someone using Apple Maps. So we're seeing progress, but as you can imagine, we're not going to be seeing any peace symbols coming up in North Korea anytime soon. There are also a few unresolved issues, including North Korea having done very little to actually end their nuclear program since North Korean leader Kim Jong-un and President Donald Trump met in Singapore last month. What's worse, it actually looks like Pyongyang is purposefully stalling instead of acceding to Trump's denuclearization demand. And this should surprise exactly nobody, because North Korea, well, they like their nukes, apparently even more than they like food. Those delaying tactics have even led to some ridiculous events. Like a month ago when
Secretary of State Mike Pompeo went to North Korea last week to continue high-level talks, some people expected he would meet with Kim Jong-un like he did on his last visit in April. The secretary was snubbed and Kim was nowhere to be seen, which we now know may have been because he had an important meeting with some potatoes. Yes, potatoes. Boil them, mash them, stick them in a stew.
You say potato and I say Pompeo. That might have been a blessing in disguise, though, because, and this is true, Pompeo as a gift brought a copy of Elton John's Rocket Man CD. Because I've heard if you're looking for a guy who doesn't take himself too seriously and can take a joke, Kim Jong-un's your guy. Are we trying to start a war here? I think a better gift would have been a half-used $25 Amazon gift card. Yeah, he might have blown us off, although it's North Korea, so who knows. We have food? Cancel everything! The meeting without Kim Jong-un must have been pretty awkward, though, because Pompeo instead met with Kim Jong-chul, who said he was only authorized to receive a letter Trump wrote to the North Korean leader. And the meeting only lasted 1 hour. My question is, how does that meeting last an hour? Oh, you're only authorized to take this letter? Well, here. So, have you seen any good movies? Oh, foreign movies are banned in North Korea. 59 minutes left. How about that Dennis Rodman? He's wacky. Now that we've been over the history, what is happening today?
And now this, North Korea urging President Trump to drop sanctions. And this request comes just days after a UN report states nuclear and missile programs in North Korea were not halted, as the North Koreans have promised.
They're in the process of dismantling that one rocket facility. Well, I tried to figure out the details on that one, but unfortunately the report he's citing is confidential, and I have the security clearance of Google. Reuters was allowed to read it because, we're Reuters and we sip tea with our pinky out. According to them, North Korea has not stopped its nuclear and missile programs and continued to defy Security Council resolutions through a massive increase in illicit ship-to-ship transfers of petroleum products, as well as through transfers of coal at sea during 2018. To clarify, saying that they didn't stop is still perfectly consistent with the dismantling of that one testing facility, because you can slow without stopping. What's with this petroleum thing, though? Well, the United Nations previously placed sanctions on petroleum coming into North Korea, but it appears China has continued to send fuel into the country, helping to bring gas prices back down and easing the pressure on Kim's economy. So China is basically the mom who agrees with your dad that you need to go to your room without dinner. But then we'll slip you a little something so you don't get too hungry. Don't tell your father! So, there are a few things going on right now that will influence the future of this North Korea negotiation. First is the UN. Remember those sanctions? Well, North Korea thinks that 55 returned soldiers' remains and demolishing that one test site warrant a waning of those sanctions. And they know just where to go to get reliable advice on how dependable the US is when it comes to removing sanctions.
After Pompeo left, Ri said Pyongyang was alarmed by U.S. intentions and complained about U.S. calls to maintain sanctions. After that, he traveled to Iran, where President Hassan Rouhani told him the U.S. can't be trusted because Trump pulled out of a 2015 deal to lift sanctions on Tehran.
Oh man, those are two countries I do not want to see giving each other advice. Come on though, North Korea. If you're going to Iran for advice on U.S. sanctions, I can save you a flight and tell you, not a fan. That's like going to Willie Nelson to see what he thinks about legalizing weed. So North Korea is saying they're doing enough to justify the loosening of sanctions, while at the same time, 3 months ago we saw
the U.S. last week made a request to the UN Security Council to halt all oil shipments to North Korea, saying the regime has been violating sanctions. China and Russia, however, are saying that they won't let that happen unless there's enough evidence that North Korea indeed violated sanctions.
Well, that certainly isn't a good sign for aggressive new sanctions. The same country that is allegedly helping North Korea evade sanctions is calling fake news regarding UN reports that North Korea is evading sanctions. There's one final sticking point in all this. Recently, Pompeo presented a timeline to North Korea calling for a 60 to 70% reduction in their warheads in 8 months. Well, that doesn't sound like a sticking point at all. Until you realize that it is unclear how many warheads North Korean leader Kim Jong-un has, making it very difficult to verify that Pyongyang has actually turned over an agreed-upon percentage. And let me tell you, estimates vary wildly, from Stockholm International Peace Research Institute saying 10 to 12 warheads in 2017, to that same year, reports saying the US now is putting North Korean arsenals at up to 60 nuclear weapons. So our predictions might have more range than their ICBMs. Yeah, just 60% of one of those two wildly different numbers should do. Don't worry though, we have a solution.
President Trump is prepared to send Secretary of State Mike Pompeo back to Pyongyang to keep the dialogue between the two sides going at the highest level.
Yeah, send him back. Maybe Kim Jong-un can go check out a gas station or something. And he can have a meeting with someone else who's only authorized to take gifts. He may go even higher though, as on August 6th it was reported.
A source familiar with Pyongyang's position on denuclearization tells CNN a second meeting between Kim Jong-un and President Trump could take place sometime later this year. Time and place to be determined.
So right now, who knows? We're in a weird place where our Secretary of State and our National Security Advisor are wanting to increase sanctions on North Korea, leading their leadership to write press releases almost directly to our president, saying that officials are going against him and that he should start easing some of those sanctions. On the bright side, the conversation has shifted from, oh god, we're all gonna die, to, you know, North Korea might not be doing enough fast enough. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hey YouTube, if you want to support independent journalism investigating Trump's cabinet, subscribe to our YouTube channel for weekly episodes. And as always, thank you for watching.